There are two blocks with the word broadcast in them. One is called broadcast, and one is broadcast and wait. Most of the time, we're going to want to use broadcast and wait, and we'll look at why. Here I have some scripts, and some of them are a little bit counterintuitive. This first one makes sense. I say play sound meow until done, and I have three copies of that block. So when I run that script, I should hear meow three times. Sounds good. This one's more counterintuitive. It says play sound meow, and again, I have three copies. But when I double click on it to run it, I only hear meow once. Listen. To understand why this is, let's look at an example with variables. Here I have a script that sets x to 0 and then changes x by 1 three times. When I double click on this, we can watch the variable x change, and it's going to change really quickly. I'll double click on it. It went so quickly we could never even see that at one point x was 1 and at one point x was 2. So in Scratch, these three blocks get run really quickly. The play sound meow until done is different. Before it does the next block, it waits for that meow sound to finish. So that's how we can hear it three times. This one, where we don't wait until it's done, it goes just as quickly as we changed x. So you can imagine, as quickly as I can, I say, play sound meow, play sound meow, play sound meow. Except even faster, right? Just like we saw with the variables. And how Scratch responds to those three requests to play sound meow that happen almost at the same time is we can only hear one meow. Let's listen. If we put a wait in between each of these, we would hear each meow. Listen. So the difference between play sound meow until done and play sound meow is that play sound meow doesn't have that wait built in. There's a similar situation with broadcast blocks. Here we have two copies of broadcast, play notes, and wait. Here's a hat block that says, when I receive, play notes. And it's going to play the note 63 times. Listen to what that sounds like. So now when I double click on this script, it'll send a message, play notes, and this script will receive that message and play note 63 times. Once it finishes, then we'll broadcast play notes again. This will receive that message and play note 60 another three times. So when I double click on this, I should hear the note 60 six times. Cool. What happens here when I broadcast play notes without the and wait? It's just like above with the play sound meow. I'll send the message play notes and then send the message again play notes again so quickly that actually I'll only hear this script run once. Let's listen. Working with play sound meow without the until done and working with broadcast without the and wait can be pretty complicated. You're almost always going to want to use the version that says until done or and wait so that you don't have to put in the wait 1 second yourself.